Imagine you have a bed of limestone whose surface has been scraped clear by the ice, and it's then colonized by woodland. Also imagine that this bed of limestone is put under pressure, perhaps it's next to a geological fault, and that means that it cracks, creating a series of joints. And then the carbon dioxide in the air dissolves in the moisture, so it rains weak carbonic acid. This then goes in the joints in the limestone and dissolves them away, creating these crevices that can be many meters deep. And then if this area is cleared in Neolithic times and grazed, you have a community that looks like this. You have the areas of bare rock, which are called clints, and you have the interspersing crevices called grykes. I remember them as grykes go in the ground and clints face the clouds. This looks like a pavement, so this habitat is called a limestone pavement. It's a very scarce habitat. The complexity of this structure means that there are different microclimates right next to each other, so remarkable diversity of different species. So they're species that just occur in areas of bare rocks. There are communities of limestone specialists. Deep in the grykes, where it is dark and damp, there are fern communities. There are communities of woodland species that have persisted since it was once woodland and occur now in the dark, soil-rich areas. And this diversity of microhabitats next to each other and these rather arduous conditions, that means common species are outcompeted, means that this is a very diverse and ecologically interesting habitat.